Hi friends, welcome to our channel. In the previous sessions, we had discussed one more type of rule model, that is learning ordered rule list. So in this approach, we are defining a rule and predict the examples that satisfies the rule and identify the examples that satisfy the rule and group them as a class. But this is completely opposite to the previous one. In this, how the rules are learned? The rules are learned for one class at a time. In this approach, the rules are learned for one class at a time. What is the meaning of this one? The meaning of this one means, in the previous session, we are considering one example. Suppose the example contains 5 positive classes and 5 negative. Suppose 5 statements, 5 positive statements and 5 negative statements. Assume we have two types of classes. One is a positive class and another one is negative class. In rule models, our concentration is only on the true class. For example, I am defining a rule for this positive class. Observe the point. Rules are learned for one class at a time. Suppose I am defining a rule. I have created a rule for this positive class. That means, based on this rule, all the positive statements, that is all the positive examples, comes under positive class. Obviously, the examples or the instances that are not covered under this rule are treated as negative class. That means, we are creating the rules for class. The examples that are covered or comes under positive class. The examples that are not covered are comes under negative class. For example, P1, P2, P5, N1, N2, N5. 5 positive statements and 5 negative statements. We are discussing in the last session. We are discussing the last session that contains 5 positive examples and 5 negative examples. Okay. Suppose the futures are length, gills, beak, teeth. So if you have any doubt, move to the previous session. In the previous session, detailedly I will read the example. So length, gills, beak, teeth, these are the 4 features with 5 positive and 5 negatives. Now, in which approach we are defining an unordered rule list? Simply, our aim is only for positive class. Suppose if length is equal to 3. In this statement, length has 3 values. Either length is equal to 3 or length is equal to 4 and length is equal to 5. Suppose if length is equal to 3, I have treated this as a class as a positive. That means, among all these statements, if length is equal to 3, obviously that is considered as a positive class. By this statement, in those 10, 2 statements are covered. Suppose 2 positive statements are comes under this rule. For example, if gills is equal to no and length is equal to 5, assume class as a positive. Please observe the previous video clearly explains, if gills is equal to no and length is equal to 5, automatically that statement belongs to positive class. Here also 2 positive classes are covered. Suppose one more positive class is, if gills is equal to no and teeth is equal to many, then it is also considered as a positive class. It covers the single positive. That is, what I am doing is, I am defining a rule for positive classes. I am defining the set of rules. Here the rules are not in any order. Suppose in the previous session, the rules are compulsory in order. But here the rules are not in any order, because if length is equal to 3, it covers 2 examples. For this rule, it satisfies 1 statement. So there is no need of any order. That is, there is no need of any if-else statements. Okay, this is the approach. The approach is very simple. Take one class, identify the rules such that the set of examples comes under this class. Obviously, the examples that are not satisfy these rules, the examples that are not satisfy these rules are comes under negative class. This is unordered rule list. In unordered rule list, actually in ordered rule list, we are concentrating on minimizing the value of p, minimum of p comma 1 minus p. Our aim is to minimize this value. That is, for such heuristic, we have to minimize this value. But in unordered rule list, we are moving to maximize the p value. So here we are using maximize the p value. We already know what is the p. P is empirical probability for a positive class. That means we are maximizing the empirical probability for a positive class, means more number of examples are covered by this rule, and this is called precision. Here the measurement is, we are using is precision. Okay, here only single point. The single point is the rules are learned for one class at a time. For example, you have two classes, positive and negative. By considering the previous example, this is an example. By considering the previous example, by this rule, two positive classes are covered. Suppose if I am using this rule, two positive statements are covered. Suppose by using this statement, the remaining single positive statement is covered. And obviously the remaining all are considered as negative class. Now we will move to the algorithm. Then rule list of, suppose D is the set of instances. This is algorithm. Now what is the input? Input is D, the set of instances. Output is R. R is a rule list, that is the set of rules that comes under that class. Okay, what is the first step? First step is the entire procedure is almost similar to the order rule list. But only differentiate is, here we are iterating over a class. In the previous approach, we are iterating over the set of instances. Now in this approach, we are iterating over classes. Suppose, for each class Ci, do. For each class Ci, do. So initially R value is 5, that is the rule set does not contain anything. Suppose Di. Assume the set of instances are di, while di, suppose the set of instances di contains examples of class ci, what is the meaning of this one? I already designated a class. From the set of instances, I am picking one instance. Instance are examples. Suppose if di contains the examples of class ci, that is di has some examples that comes under class ci, then what we will do? Automatically the instances are arranged to class ci. So for this, if it contains, we are defining a rule. Suppose, so algorithm is len rule for class of, suppose this is a separate algorithm, we are defining a single rule. How a single rule applied? Len rule for class of di, ci, that is the set of instances and class ci. Whenever we are getting a rule, the rule is appended. The rule is appended to this one. Finally, our set of instances becomes di, such that suppose x belongs to di. What is the meaning of this one? Here what we are doing is, whenever an example is covered by that class, we have to remove that example. That means for the next iteration, no need to consider. For example, in the example length is equal to 3, two positive rules are covered. Then we have to remove those two positive. Otherwise, the two positives are again comes into consideration for the next rules also. You got it? Each and every time we have to reduce the number of instances, that is that ei value becomes di by, that is we have to remove some examples. What are the examples? X is covered by R. If any instance that is covered by R, those instances are removed and modify the data set. The instances are removed and modify the data set. This is end of the while loop. This is end of the for loop. And finally, we have to return R. Okay, this is the crucial step. What we are doing here? We are removing the positives. For example, my entire prediction is for positive examples. In this case, we are removing the positives. Removing the positive means the set of instances that are already covered by this rule are removed. In the next iteration, suppose some other set covers this rule, those are removed. Step by step, we are removing the positives. This is the Len rule list algorithm. Okay, our concept is very simple. For each and every class, we are iterating over a class. Suppose I am using first positive class. For this class, I am picking one rule, check the rule. If the rule is satisfied by the examples, remove those examples and perform iteration. Perform iteration. Okay, this is clear. Now we will move to the second algorithm. The algorithm is how we are defining a single rule. Algorithm, suppose the algorithm name is Len rule for class. So the parameters are di, ci. So what is the input? Input is di comma ci. What is the output? A single rule R. Input is di comma ci. Output is a single rule R. So what is the first step? Suppose I am using a variable b with a value true. Okay, and L actually L is a set of all available instances. So here L is set of all available instances. That means instances means set of all available letters. Set of all available letters. C, set of all classes. Set of all possible classes. So here no need. We are already using C. So B and L. While not homogeneous of, you already know what is homogeneous. Based on the purity, we are calculating homogeneity. That means the two are either mutually exclusive or mutually not exclusive. While not homogeneous of D, that is if the two examples are different, then only we are defining a rule. If the two examples are same, then no need of a rule because both comes under same group. While not homogeneous of D, first step, we are defining a variable small l. The variable identifies the best literal. So the algorithm in this case is almost similar to the previous one. The main difference is in best literal of di, li, ci. Additional one is this one, that is we are identify the best literal with regard to the class. In the previous example, that is in the previous algorithm, learning ordered rule list, it is based on the available instances. But here available instances along with the class, that is each and every step we have to consider the class also. Whenever we are getting b tends to, that means here simple terms, B is the rule that is generated. Now D. D becomes the set of instances. Suppose D becomes DI. Suppose X belongs to DI such that X is covered by B. X is covered by B. And L becomes, so the set of available instances. That is the set of available letters. We have to step by step reduce the available letters L such that, suppose L dash belongs to L, L dash belongs to L such that L dash is same future as L. See this one. L dash belongs to L. L dash is a same future of L. Suppose if any this one, the rule satisfies this one, we are removing those instances. We are removing those instances. Finally, this is end of. And the last statement is if we are written the class, if B, that means if any rule exists, then class is equal to CI. See the example. The entire example is same. Here this is the difference. We are predicting based on the class only. This is learning unordered rule list. Thank you.